don't care if I miss you. I'm moving on as far as I can see.
We are celebrating the fact that we've actually reached the stage where I can say we've got our 100th guest in the studio. And never, I put on Facebook earlier, never ever in my wildest dreams did I think that we would get to this stage. And now I'm thinking, let's get to 200. And our 100th guest, and I've got to say, it's always a pleasure to welcome Sean C. Kennedy to the Urban Beat FM studio.
Thanks for having me.
Sean, I mean, it is great to have you. And you've been on the show a few times.
Quite a few. Over the years, I guess.
Over the years, yes. And I remember someone saying to me a while back, if Sean's on the show again, we need to give him the keys to the station.
it's becoming a joke, isn't it?
But it's always good to have you. And we have got something for you rather than the keys. I'll give you that a little bit later on.
Okay.
So I will. So how's life been for you? I reckon it's been about maybe a year since you've been on the show. I'm not sure.
I think so. Maybe last winter or something like that.
Yeah.
It's good. I'm writing new songs, and we just had the conversation that the album's not even a year old yet.
I know.
But it's still doing its thing, and everyone's still enjoying it. So I'm writing a lot, which is good. Writing a new direction, but one that's not. It's
feels good. We are going to be playing the latest song, Legacy, just in a minute or two. Yeah. But I thought your build up to that was very good. All of a sudden, nobody knew. Then you just put out on Facebook, Legacy.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Now my first instinct was to actually get in touch with you. Send me the track. But do you know,
that was really good though that you didn't. I quite liked that.
I thought, no, I'm gonna get into this. Mm-hmm. I am gonna order it myself, and I'm gonna get up on the morning of that and listen to it like many other people. Cool. And I've got to say, the track just blew me away.
Yeah, it's definitely different from what I've been doing, which is.
So what was the influence for that? I mean, that change in style, the change in songwriting, and also the change in production.
Yeah, totally. I mean, the last year, the first song that I'd written in like 8 months, because the album came out, I hadn't been writing at all, just ideas, and the song was Colder. I've played a few times live, which hopefully we'll have out soon, but that was the first song in ages, and that was the kind of change of... The songs are almost like they've got a bit more depth in them, and they seem darker in the sound of them. It's got a bit more substance in the song and depth. So that was a kind of change. And then the start of the year, to be fair, when the album came out, a good friend of mine now is Mark Price, that's doing really well on the circuit. He does his Card Trickery and Illusion and stuff like that, and he's excellent. But he came to the weekend that I released the album last year. He came along to the gig. I did one of the nights in Harley's.
Yeah.
And I came off stage and I hadn't even put my guitar down, and I kind of recognised his face. And we had actually met previously at Sue Casa when they used to do gigs in there, like years ago.
Yeah.
When I had started out. And he said, "Can I show you a card trick?" And I'm like, "All right, we'll put my guitar down."
Yeah.
So we kind of went round the corner and he showed me this trick, and it just blew my mind. He actually had the number 77 on one of the cards.
Wow.
I wasn't expecting it, and that's probably the best thing about it.
So where's the synergy there?
So when we just kind of kept in touch, and then I was doing the Girl on Christopher Street video in New York. It was a Kickstarter project, so people could pay for the and they would get rewards out of it and stuff like that. And one of the rewards is we'd either write a song together or do music for something. So Mark asked, could you do a soundtrack for the opening of the show? And I said, that'd be really cool. So we just got chatting about stuff, and we had a lot in common about just our approach on the way we think and stuff like that. So we just back and forth, we just sent a lot of messages and stuff like that. And when we decided we were going to do music, I was like, just send me some stuff and we'll get chatting. And we're talking about life and different things, all sorts of stuff. And we kind of just, he was just sending little bits, and he was just sparking something. And I just come up with this first line, "We might never get to Neverland." And I was like, I don't know where it came from. It just came out, and I sent him it. It says, "What do you think of that for a starter?" And he's like, "Love it, absolutely love it." And the music, I don't know why I can't play the mandolin, but I picked the mandolin up and just played these few chords, and it stemmed from there. And that three chords runs right through the song, and then we just built run about it, myself and engineer producer that I work with, Dave McLean. So he's we've had a good relationship over the last 5 years. We just maybe 2-3 times a week we just get together and work on stuff. So that was a total experiment thing that was probably the best way to go about it.
And it's like,
for new music that I was doing. And then bit by bit, I started to finish the song. It was really good. We're building the track and an atmosphere in the track. And almost like it comes across almost like a soundtrack or something from a film. And it was just painting pictures in my head, and I thought the lyrics just started to roll off the tongue after that. And all the lyrics are separate, though. They're not like, sometimes it doesn't feel as if it's all together. Yeah. But every line's got something in it that relates to somebody, or it sets a tone.
So, I was recording the thoughts for the day with a minister.
Right, yeah.
And she said to me, "Who have you got on the show tonight?" And I went, "Well, I've got singer-songwriter Sean Z. Kennedy. Mm-hmm. Let me hear something of his stuff." And I put on Legacy. And she said within 15 seconds of that song starting, the hairs in the back of her neck were standing.
Man, there you go.
Anyway, I think what we'll do, Sean, we'll play the track.
Cool.
Sean C. Kennedy there and his latest single, Legacy. Now, Sean, we were saying there, that was a totally different change in style.
Yes.
Is that the kind of style that your songwriting's going in now?
I think, not every song's going to have mandolin in it, but definitely that, like I said before, the depth that's in the song.
I was going to say, because you get that depth, you
more
get
layers and stuff like that.
Layers and layers of music there.
Yeah, kind of having a lot of space in the songs as well, and time to think about it. You don't know you're doing it, but you're giving space to think about what's just been said, kind of thing.
Now, you're going to do some songs for us tonight, and very kindly, as soon as he's 100 guests, he's left all the choices up to me. So I've picked a track from the album 77, and do you know, Sean, I got some brand new speakers from my stereo, and the first album I played on it.
Oh, look at that.
Was 77.
You're just saying that because it's tonight.
No, it's very, very true, and it sounded pretty good, I'll tell you. Anyway, you're going to do a song. I've picked the Somewhere Yesterday, which was the opening track.
Yeah.
From 77.
Yeah, let's do that then.
Yep. Anyway, take it away.
The rhythm of the rain on my window pane, it never ceases to amaze me. And every single day, nothing seems to change apart from how I'm feeling lately. 'Cause this west wind has been blowing in my face too long. Oh, somewhere no one knows a thing about me out there, where I can be myself. Somewhere that you can take a magic carpet and just fly away so far away. And nowhere, somewhere yesterday. Yeah, yeah. When summertime is near and then it disappears, I can't remember any autumn. But then it starts to snow, the winter lets me know. Another year goes by and I just sit and I wonder why my feet have been sinking in the quicksand from my hometown. Oh, somewhere no one knows a thing about me out there, where I can be myself. Somewhere that you can take a magic carpet and just fly away so far away. And nowhere, somewhere yesterday. knows a thing about me out there, and well, I can be myself somewhere, that you can take a magic carpet and just fly away, so far away and nowhere, and nowhere, and somewhere yesterday, yeah, oh. Thank you.
There is Sean C. Kennedy live on Wednesday night sessions here on 107.2 Irvine BFM. Now, get some messages there. I've got Fiona and Dorai saying, sounding good so far. The first track that you played has a new Americana vibe, very New York City, she's saying.
Okay.
And then I've got Ben Grant, he's actually playing the sympathy vote here, so he is. He said, if you're taking requests, he's in his sick bed. Mm-hmm. He said, can you do him Emily sometime during the show?
Totally, definitely.
We'll get that.
Cool, thanks.
In between Sean singing and chatting, we're going to play a track from bands and artists who have actually been on the show over the past 3 years. And I remember being stunned, and Peter, who's filming at the moment, will back me up, where we had a young guy called Matt Scott come in, yes, in the studio. And he just blew us all away. From Matt's debut EP, this is Untitled. That's Matt Scott there, and Untitled from a Stairways EP. Looking forward to some new recordings from Matt very soon. And I'm very intrigued, because Sean, on Facebook the other day there, mm-hmm, Matt was actually saying to Colin Hunter, the two of us should do something.
I know.
They'd been talking about it, and I've just said, why don't you do it on this show?
I should.
So I'm hoping they take me up on the offer.
Good.
And it'll be great to get Matt back in the studio, and Colin as well, because it's been a long time since Colin was in the studio. Now, you are going to do a song for Ben, but first, I know you've been up in Edinburgh doing mm-hmm some festival dates. How did that all go?
Good. I've just been playing at the open stages. Nothing fancy about them, but great fun.
Lots of people go to them, that's it.
People get to chill out, and I mean, mostly people are there for the drink.
Of course they are.
But they put they have acts running all the way like from the afternoon right through to 10, 11 o'clock at night. And it's great, because it's like an hour set as well. You get to play a good bunch of songs. And the thing is, most of the people that have come up and spoke to me afterwards are from Spain and different countries and all that. So
that's amazing.
So it's good. And we had fun. I had Josh Fraser up with me.
You had Aidan up with
you? Aidan, John Blightley as well. So,
yeah.
And then myself and just Aidan, we played on Saturday afternoon, which the place was packed. But it's great. I never spend enough time in Edinburgh.
Edinburgh's,
and when I do go there at that time, it's good.
I mean, being brought up in Glasgow, you kind of get that thing, oh, Glasgow, don't like Edinburgh, but Edinburgh is a fabulous city.
It is. And it's very international,
Yeah, definitely, I would totally mm-hmm agree with you. Yeah. Now, you're going to play a song for Ben.
Yes.
In his sick bed, just before he falls asleep. This will be like his serenade.
Talk about a lullaby, Ben.
A lullaby. I know. Anyway, live on Wednesday night sessions here on 107.2 Urban Beat FM, our 100th guest, I still can't get my head around that, it's Sean C. Kennedy, and he's going to do Emily.
Great, okay.
What's up, Emily? You look so sad to me. It's not how it's meant to be. So why do you look so sad? You bring out the best in me, and you do it easily. But don't frown, just smile for me, 'cause you bring out the best in me. Even when the rain falls down and I just can't face it, you find a way to lift my spirits,
and you see something in me. Oh, Emily. Oh, Emily. Oh, what's up, Emily? Don't turn your back on me. Why won't you talk to me? Don't turn your back on me. We don't have to agree to get on famously, but come down and sit with me. We will be alright, yes, even when the rain falls down. And I just can't face it. You find a way to lift my spirits, and you see it's something in me. Oh, Emily. Oh, Emily. And even when the rain falls down, and I just can't face it, you find a way to lift my spirits. You see something in me. You see something in me. You see something in me. Oh, Emily. Oh, Emily.
Hope you're happy there. That's your request from Sean. That's your lullaby for tonight. It's 107.2 Urban Beat FM. In the studio, we have our 100th guest, Sean C. Kennedy. Now, Sean, you wrote that song. It's a wee while ago now. What age is Emily now?
She's 8.
Wow.
Yes, just turned, I think, 9 she just turned, so
yeah.
That's a good few years ago.
I remember you performing that song for the first time. I think you'd only written it at another radio station that I used to be at.
That's right.
It's a great wee song.
It is. It's fun, and it's a lot of the kind of younger ones that listen to, like family, friends. That's what they get
some of them. Can you write a song for me, Sean?
Oh, my next door neighbour, my friend Lindsay, Emily's mum. She mentions that Emily's friends would say if there's a birthday party, and I remember I'd come in with a card and stuff like that with the family, and when I left, they said, "Is that the guy that's the singer?" And then they say, and they were kind of like nudging and said, "How do we get in like a music video and get?" Because the girls were in, course, you don't have to feel lonely. And they were nudging them, "How do you get into a music video and how do you get a song written for you?" But that's a song that's kind of for the younger ones. I've got a friend and she's working in Kenya just now.
Yeah.
And she's a school teacher. She's kind of a private teacher for these young kids. And they're like travelling through like safari with these open Jeep. Emily's blasting through the speakers. But she said, if I hear it one more time, like they play it.
Constant.
Little girls like, play it again, play it again, play it again. So it's constant. But
wow.
It's the one that gets them going again.
That's The Outlawed on 107.2 Urban Beat FM on Wednesday night sessions with me, Ronnie McGhie, celebrating our 100th guest. And yep, still stunned at that. You've heard me say that. 100th guest tonight. It had to be the only person that I wanted to come in was Sean C. Kennedy. Basically, Sean, because although people say, oh, you're supporting local artists, indirectly, you've been supporting me as well.
Yes, by coming in. Everyone is.
Yep, that's it. Anyway, next week, although I've been telling everybody it's this week, next week you're heading off to Nashville, and that is becoming like your spiritual home.
Yep, that's the land of songwriting, that's where it's all happening. I guess between when you go to the States, over here it's like London is the hub that connects to Nashville and LA and New York, but Nashville's the, all the companies from New York are moving to Nashville.
What's the vibe like?
It's busy. It's busy, but not in like a too much kind of thing. It's just constant. It's just music all the time.
And you're saying you've got now, like, there's a whole industry there now. People have moved out there.
There's 100 people move there per day.
Wow.
At some point, it's going to have to.
Yeah,
like,
Nashville's not. It's not a massive city.
It's not huge. No, it's a city, but it's a small town as well, kind of thing. Everyone kind of knows each other. But yeah, it's 100 people. It might have been more than that, but at some point, they've got to, like, say that's enough.
I know.
They're knocking down houses and building three stories. Yeah.
I was going to say, just need to lock the gate somewhere.
But it's going to be the next New York and the next Vegas, all in the one. All the even for business, like the whole Wall Street thing in New York, the business is flying in Nashville. There's buildings going up everywhere.
Wow.
But it's tight, though. It's really small, so at some point it's going to
still
happen.
Got that kind of small-town feel?
Definitely.
Even though you look on these skyscrapers?
Yeah, they've got... it's very well known when you come in, either from the airport or whatever, and you see the city from far off. It's the... is it A&T, they call it? It's like T-Mobile kind of thing, A&T. And the building's like that. It's like the Bat... They call it the Bat Building. The roof's got like that. So it's like Batman Building. That's what they call it.
So what is... What's your trip for?
I'm going over to do some writing. So, it's going to be a good trip. Working with some guys that have written some really cool songs. So, yeah, it's going to be good. It's a different... it's a shorter trip than usual. Even though last trip was like 3 weeks... But the whole US trip was like eight weeks all in, but Nashville was three.
Now, I know in the past you've written a lot with your dad.
Yeah.
What's it like now actually writing with people out there?
It's great. The thing is, it's really well known when maybe someone like a publisher sets you up with a writer or something like that, and you go online and check them out to see what they've done or what's their songs like. And when I wrote Slow Me Down, I wrote Slow Me Down with a guy called Chris Winward in Nashville. And that was one of those ones was like, I've never met the guy. It's like, I have to check that. Oh, no, he's not got much stuff online. I don't know what I'm going into. And that's probably the best thing about it when you don't know. And you go in. And we went into this the little room is smaller than this, maybe half the size. And CSAC, which is a kind of, it's like ASCAP and BMI. In this small room, and within a couple of hours we'd written a song, but just totally just sparked something. So it can happen. Anybody, it could be anybody, even if you're not a songwriter, they could say something that just sparked.
I mean, we all know from back in the 1960s, I mean, they had songwriters in booths like Carole King, Jerry Goffin, for examples. Like, that was their job.
For hire as well.
That was their job. They sat in a booth, you have to write 10 hit songs in
a week.
That's it, That's it. Are you an outer job? Mm-hmm. I mean, how do you find, like, when, like, do you know when it's working right away?
When you get a feeling, or like when I get a feeling about an idea, like straight away, when Legacy, I mean, I'm not turning around saying Legacy's like the best song ever, but just the first line in general, just I knew straight away. I've not heard anyone say anything like that, and it just, can I say that? And it's like,
of course I can.
So it's like, don't be afraid to put anything out there. I mean, it does make sense, like a lot of the lyrics in that song. You can't just say anything, but almost in a way you can. There's been a lot of hits over the years, and you're thinking,
of course, what does that mean?
Chris Martin doesn't make sense, even though he's a genius. Yeah. Doesn't make sense all the time. So there's a kind of, the music plays a big part in it.
Now, obviously, social media is a big part of music now as well. It's how people communicate. Now, I was very intrigued. Like, I remember Taylor Dukes from the gig up at your dad's place. Yeah. And I thought she was a great singer.
Yeah.
And she said to you that you've written a song together and she'd love to get it recorded.
Mm-hmm. Well, she said the other night when I basically put a post up to let my friends know I've come back out.
Yeah.
And I tied, like, 45 like almost 50 people, and
that's right.
And my friend Aiden's like, but are you really going to be able to catch up with them all? It's like as if I was like trying to show off, I've got all these friends in Nashville. But but Taylor came, she commented and said, that'd be good, we could do something, maybe record that song that we've written. But there's loads of songs that I've done with friends that I've not
but don't not get recorded.
Yeah, well, not that they don't, I've just not kind of push them on. They might come out like in a couple of years' time, but that'd be good. Yeah.
Is that a song that would, if it was recorded,
it was really good.
Would that be a duet? Yeah.
As it works with a duet. That's why Taylor, she's got so much class and her performance and the way she sings and her writing and all that. And it's just, it just oozes for me. Yeah, she's just, she's got that class. It just constantly just runs. Even when she's talking to you, she's got a mannerism about herself. But yeah, I think that's maybe when I hear it again, I'm like, why did I not do something else about it?
that happens though. Yeah. Now, I remember your first collaboration I remember was on Emma Jane's Workhorse album, Old and Grey. It's a cracking track. Played that the other week there, and it still sounds good.
Emma Jane's another.
She's a great talent as well.
Ridiculous talent. Like, just doing her thing.
Well, she's getting back into it now.
Totally.
She's got the family.
Of course, but you don't lose it. You don't lose the talent.
Anyway, going to play a track now. We're actually going to play a track that Taylor brought out earlier on this year. Great. This is Taylor Dukes and Blowing Smoke. As Sean and I were saying there, a good track, it just comes to an end. I mean, she's got a style.
Yeah.
It's a great style. And of course, one of the other girls, Caitlin, she's actually released something new as well.
Yeah, a new single. A new video too.
I still play her album regularly.
Her voice is infectious.
Between High and Goodbye.
It's infectious,
very, very infectious. Now, Sean, you're going to do something new for us.
Yeah,
now.
I'll play a new song Oops. There goes the Facebook Live.
There you go.
Ah, we're still here.
Yes.
Yeah, I'll do a new song. This is called Skydance. Brand new one.
Nice.
We just played rehearsed with it today with the full band, so yeah, excited about it. That'll work. Headphones off if you don't mind.
Yeah, okay.
How's the view from up there now? Now you're no longer here. I'm standing in line. It's getting harder to breathe. I won't be far behind you. It's you that I need. Ooh, will you wait for me? Wait for me. Ooh, when I close my eyes, it's you I see. And you're dancing in your favorite dress. I've got you spinning in a pirouette. I wouldn't wanna be anywhere else. It's you and me forever and ever. It's you. You're the reason I wake up. It's true. There's so much space here to take up. I can't stay here any longer with this broken heart. I'm missing you like crazy. I'm falling apart. Ooh, will you wait for me? Wait for me. Ooh, when I close my eyes, it's you I see. And you're dancing in your favorite dress. I've got you spinning in a pirouette. I wouldn't wanna be anywhere. It's you and me forever and ever. It's you and me forever and ever. So will you wait for me? Please will you wait for me? Though my heart is breaking, I've got you on my mind. I promise that I'll make it.
But it might take some time. Just give me all your patience and I'll figure it out. Just give me levitation and I'll find you somehow. Will you wait for me? Wait for me. Ooh. When I close my eyes, it's you I see. Now you're dancing in your favorite dress. I've got you spinning a pirouette. I wouldn't wanna be anywhere else. It's you and me forever and ever. It's you and me forever and ever.
Sean C. Kennedy live on 107.2 Irvine Beat FM. Now, Sean, I know you are a prolific songwriter. Are these songs just songs you're writing and performing, or are these songs potentially going to be for album number two?
Oh, definitely. There'll be, when production comes around, yeah, you'll hear the kind of like the soundtrack thing will be coming back again. Yeah. Just trying to lift them a bit, atmosphere and, like, Paint pictures.
Yes.
Even just the music itself, but the lyrics will, yeah, especially that one. I mean, that's something that I'm sure it will relate to every single person.
Yeah. Next song up, we have a band that we were both down in Kowinning watching last week, November Lights.
Of course, yeah. Yeah.
Talented
yeah,
guys
are doing, and they're just getting better and better every
they
time.
They are.
It's great to watch, actually. Yeah, they were actually in rehearsing after the band today. But yeah, they're doing great. They've got a lot more shows coming up in September, I believe. So,
and of course, they've got their new single going to be coming out. Yeah. Is it Speak a Little Louder? Or is it Talk a Little? Speak a Little Louder. Yeah.
And it may be Talk.
Talk a Little Louder. I'm not sure. I think it's Speak a Little Louder because they've got the song called Talk, which is a great song.
Yeah, it's a great song as well.
Great song as well. They must have enough material now for an album.
They have. They've got James is writing all the time, and I believe they've got a couple of new songs that they've three of the guys have done together. Yeah. So it's good, it's coming on.
I remember, I mean, we've had 3/5 of November Lights in the studio. We had Scott, we had Josh, and we had James performing last year. But way back, rewind 2 years ago, we had Scott and James in.
Yeah.
And I remember James sitting there with a keyboard
big
like
keyboard,
that. Yeah. I mean, it was a great session. Uh-huh. And you knew then there was a lot of talent there. And then I always remember Josh coming in for his first session.
So they've all kind of blended in together. It's great to watch because they're all great musicians.
Oh, they certainly are.
A phenomenal piano player and a good singer as well.
I still maintain this song is still a hit single in the making. This is Bring You Home.
Great.
And of course, it was great to see the guys perform in Kilwinning. It seems funny, Sean, when I say that, a gig in Kilwinning.
Yeah, it's a great little venue too.
It's a cracking venue.
YUC.
People have said to me, it's a good venue, but you kind of get a drink in it. I think it's a good venue for not having that.
It's good, actually.
So
it's really good because you don't have to rely on the drink. You have to think about drinking.
I know.
It's great. The lighting, everything, the sound of the place. It's down
They've got it. Great.
Yeah.
Anyway, also in the studio, we have, from the Irvine Times, we get Kieran Shanks. This must be like old memories for you when you used to do the talking.
I know. I was about to say, it's good to be back on air. It's been a wee while.
It has. Are you enjoying it? I mean, I got you along to kind of sample the atmosphere of a live session. What do you think?
Oh, excellent. Honestly, I mean, I've been meaning to come down for a while anyway because you and Ben had a really great thing going on with the sessions. And who would have thought 100th guests in here? And Sean obviously blown us all away with some killer tracks.
Yeah, definitely. But I'm still struggling with the fact that it's 100. I still can't believe it.
It's great, good for you though.
It is fantastic, honestly. I mean, Ronnie, you really should take a lot of credit for that as well. You're certainly a humble guy, but very, very important on the scene right across Ayrshire.
Everyone knows that as well, which is great. Yeah.
I made a point on Facebook earlier. I mean, this show it's a team effort, because I've always had Peter there who has documented so many of the sessions over the past 3 years, which people can check out on YouTube.
Yeah.
All you do is type in Irvine Beat FM sessions or Ronnie McGhie sessions, and you'll get you'll get lots and lots of great local art acts from the Shire and beyond, as we always say. And it's well worth checking out, because some of them are now becoming very, I mean, it's like an archive of where artists were at that time.
Yeah.
I mean, you look at, I mean, we've got a couple of your sessions.
Yeah, the early ones.
Early ones. And you can just see the journey that you've been on.
Yeah, yeah. It's great. It's just that little platform. Even just to tell someone, if you've started out, I'm going to do a radio.
I know.
Things, a performance.
And it's, I always said that if I got one session a month, I would be happy. But my goodness, it has really taken off. And it's good to have Kieran down.
Yes, glad
to
be here.
Do you want to spin around so you can see?
Yes, I will be. I will move a bit.
We'll do that. Because that's a bit unfair when you can't see
Ronnie. Just a wee bit, I know.
Now, why don't you've got the microphone there. Why don't you go into journalist mode and ask some questions?
I'm never out of that mode. That's why I'm down here. I'm never out of that mode.
You mean every time I say off the record, it doesn't mean anything?
Yeah, you talk about music and I'll talk about journalism.
Yeah, we'll switch it about. No, but Sean, honestly, just seeing how we're here anyway, but can I get on to the point about what we were discussing earlier about the kind of impact? How important is it still? Because, I mean, radio is still very much their bread and butter for a lot of bands for kind of getting things out there. How important is it to have that kind of platform still here at Irvine Beat?
Like, it's great. I mean, I'm not doing any other radio apart from this. So,
right.
I mean, I've done, like, I did the one up in at Pulse up in Barrhead, which was great. But aside from that, it's not like... I mean, I know there's been a few people been on, like Janice Forsyth and stuff. I've not been on that. I've not been approached. To be fair, I've dropped some CDs in, but I've not heard anything in that, and that's cool. So maybe it'll happen sooner or later. But the fact that Ronnie gets you, I mean, last time was maybe a year ago.
But I think it was about a year ago.
So it's good. You get to come out and play some new songs, and then also sometimes you do that thing where you bring in your favourite songs and play.
That's
which is great.
Yeah.
Like I said, for the younger ones as well that have not done it yet, Ronnie's like, he gives people the chance because he wants the music to get out there.
It's always funny because every time that you're coming in, it's a week later you're heading off, whether it's to New Orleans.
Right, yeah, yeah. That's right.
And then, I mean, and then we will talk about, I mean, you basically did an American tour.
Yeah. The last trip was...
It was long.
It was 8 weeks long. Matt Scott that you played earlier, Matt was out and Matt managed to get involved with some of my friends down in Nashville.
Excellent.
So it's like, if you can sort out the shows, and I'm here to help if there's anyone else if you want to get gigs across the pond, then it's good. So but having this year's just it's really good for. And the viewers, I think the viewers you get even during the day.
Yeah, absolutely. Yep, absolutely.
People are calling up, "Oh, I heard your song on the radio again."
I know.
It's great.
Yeah, it's excellent. What's your kind of, in terms of the scene at the moment, because it kind of goes through peaks and troughs, I've found, from what I've seen, where you can have a right good bust of bands coming through, whether it's just whether new releases, new EPs, new albums. What's your kind of feeling at the moment? Because you've obviously been, you've been going away from period of time, back. Yeah. What's your kind of view on it at the moment as it stands right now?
I could say, like, I just do my own thing, but I don't do my own thing and, like, disregard anything. I was not even, like, take a look what's going on. I love to see what's going on because I'm listening to hear what the songs are coming out like, because I'm just intrigued by new music. Because I want something to blow me away.
Yeah.
Everyone does, because that's just what music does to us.
Mm-hmm.
And it's great. And so, like, obviously talk about the young guys, November Lights and stuff, and then we'll talk about Tragic O'Hara as well.
Yes, bringing absolutely.
Is it
to have him back.
Yeah, yep. So and he's a character as well, because he's got passion behind his work as well, and it's very arty as well, it's visual. And I had to listen to the song that he brought out, and it's repetitive. Like, and I feel that obviously that's intentional, because
of course,
as soon as I stopped listening to it, I was singing along. So good job on Tosh for that one. But like, it's good to have him.
Yeah, absolutely. Is there anybody that we might not have heard of yet that you think that could be coming through, that could be one of the next kind of main bands, artists, singers, whoever on the Isher scene?
Trying to I think.
And future session stars, of course, of Wednesday Night Sessions.
Yeah, exactly, there you go. I mean, if there's anyone that's popped up. Not locally. I mean, I heard a young guy in Edinburgh. And
right.
He's only, the guy was only 18.
Wow.
Gus, what, maybe Harrower, his second name is, I'm just guessing. Phenomenal, like, ridiculous. Like, half kind of John Legend, half, honestly, just like really jazzy pop. Really cool.
Yeah.
But his own thing going on. I mean, locally, yeah. I mean, the bands are, I don't know what, I think Cullen are working on another record.
Yep,
is that right?
Yep.
I know that Soldier On are going back up to the same place that Cullen recorded to record.
Okay.
And I've been doing a little bit of work with Josh that plays. Josh is bringing his solo stuff out soon. So
that's what I was just about to say. That's what I was just about to say there, because Josh is a singer-songwriter and he's a brilliant guitarist. And he has come on leaps and bounds. Every time you see him, he just gets better.
Yeah, he's a real professional.
And he's got his own band now.
He has got his own band too. Yeah. So I think. It's just been really busy, and it's great that they've still got a lot of gigs with November Lights, because they're doing really well too. So he's going to look to get his own solo stuff out, but he's got a couple of really good songs there. Like, and he played a couple of them in Nashville when he came down for that last week and a half, and people were blown away by them. So yeah, I mean, yeah, I just look forward to anything new, and if there's something else that pops up.
That video that you posted from Nashville with you and Josh in it, I nearly had tears in my eyes.
Yeah. Was that the one from the listening room?
I think it was, yeah.
Yeah, it was a great... And the thing about that gig was, like, you kind of get a... If you hear, like, there's a really big venue, just say you're playing at the Bluebird in Nashville. It's on the Nashville TV show all the time, so that's the place to go. And if you found out you're going to play there, you'd be like posting for days and days about it. But I was playing in the listening room and I'd heard about it. And this has also been featured in the Nashville programme. And I was, never really thought much of it. And then I walked up and there's people queued out the door trying to get in. And I just never thought much of it. But when we posted a video, it was an amazing trip. But as you say, local talent, I just hope it keeps smashing through.
Yeah.
Absolutely. It will, though. It's a fact.
I mean, for me, there's been stuff released this year. I mean, because of this show, I'm listening to music that I probably wouldn't have listened to before.
But that's almost like your job, though, as well.
Twin Hearts EP, the Progress Decline EP. What an EP. Yeah. You've got the Belafonte's Warren Bonds EP.
That opening tracks.
Oh, stunning.
Loved it.
Stunning tracks. Mm-hmm. A lot of good music out there. And I urge bands, if they're listening to this tonight and they're bringing out music, get in touch.
Totally.
That's what I'm here for.
No brainer.
Definitely. Anyway, we are going to play some music. We have got something brand new from Sean C. Kennedy, exclusive to Wednesday Night Sessions. This is a brand new Sean track. This is Easier. Sean talking in the background there. Anyway, that is a brand new track. It's not the final product. I think, Sean, you would call that a demo. But good track. Obviously going to be in contention for the album.
Definitely, yeah. Yep.
I've got to ask, how many tracks have you actually got stored away for potential album tracks just now?
I mean, right now, I don't know, maybe like 11 or 12 or something like that. Maybe like 11 or 12 kind of strong ones, and then just keep writing it out. See how Nashville goes, and then take it from there.
Yeah. Now we know you've been struggling with your voice tonight.
It's all those cigarettes.
I know. Oh yeah.
I'll be fine. I'll be good.
One more song, and I've got to ask. I mean, this when I first heard the I took the option to... I downloaded the album and I went where I pre-ordered, downloaded it, and this was the track that for me at that time on the first listen, it was a standout track.
Great,
I know it's the track you wrote with Nick Kershaw.
I mean, I think this is one of the... It's probably one of my favourite tracks off the record.
Yeah.
I was really pleased with the way it sounded and stuff like that. It's got a mixer.
Every time I play it, though, there's another track that I like. I mean, I've got to say, when I played the album on my new speakers, I it was the Love You Owe that actually stood out on that listen.
That will, I think that will come back to life again. I think I'll maybe do another version of it or something like that.
Yeah.
Just started playing it again live, played it all the Edinburgh gigs. And maybe I've left it out a few times.
Yeah.
So maybe just revive that.
It's a case though, when you write new songs and you do have the album, but when you're doing slots like that, you're limited in your time.
Well, that's what I was talking about. So you're not making the set.
I know, that's it. But that's what happens. Yeah. And then maybe a year down the line, you say, oh, you hear it maybe. You hear it in the studio and you go, oh, maybe need
certain
to revive that.
Certain
gigs
really suit certain songs as well, like if it's a seated kind of thing. So,
so we're going to, you're going to play one last song for us, Sean. Yeah. You're going to play Watercolour Dreams.
Okay. Forget the first line of the song. I did that today, like maybe 3 or 4 times at rehearsal. It's like line blank. I'm thinking in my throat. That's a classic for me as well. When I do it in gigs, I'll forget the line. I'm like, well, here we go again. I'll stop the gig. And
I think you've got to. I think you've got to.
Okay.
Glad that the day is done, waiting for the moon to come, bringing you to me. And so I close my eyes, and how I hope that sleep arrives quick and easily in my watercolor dreams. I see you crystal clear, I hear every single word you say. But when I'm calling out to reach you, I'm reaching out to touch you. All my watercolor dreams fade away. Back to reality, awaken to a nightmare, into the cold light of day. Back to the way it was, too many long and lonely hours until I sleep again in my watercolor dreams. I see you crystal clear, I hear every single word you say. But when I'm calling out to reach you, reaching out to touch you, all my watercolor dreams fade away. Oh, how I want it to be true. Oh, like dreamers always do. Here we go again. Here we go into the night. I'll see you on the other side. In my watercolor dreams, I see you crystal clear. I hear every single word you say. But when I'm calling out to reach you, I'm reaching out to touch you. All my watercolor dreams fade away. Fade away.
Okay.
There we go. Sean C. Kennedy live on Wednesday night sessions here on 107.2 Irvine BFM. Sean, it must be great just to get back to America, back in that vibe.
Yeah, it's just it's a good environment over there. And like I said, like, I've got a bunch of friends over there now, which is good too.
I take it, it thrives creativity.
It's just constant.
Yeah.
Even, like I say, you could end up going to a stranger's house and you're booked in to write with them, you've never met them before. And then you have this connection where you're giving yourself away, you're giving away your thoughts and all that to someone else, but they're fine because they're doing the exact same thing, just to make a good song.
I'm gonna ask the question, and I know we've talked about this privately. Do you think that maybe sometime your future actually lies across the pond?
Yeah, I'd say so. Yeah. You get the thing, there's quite a few trips that I've done now, and I mean, I always feel at home here anyway. So when I go away, I always love coming back home.
Yeah.
It's probably one of the favourite parts of the trip is coming back, believe it or not. I think just even living by the sea, but sometimes don't get the good weather and all that, but it's, I think I do see myself over there, whether it's living there for a year or, depending on how things goes, how things go, I can maybe have, making bounce between the two.
Yeah. I mean, you're only gone for like a fortnight this time.
Yeah.
And the last time you were 8 weeks, I mean, that you must have settled in.
Yeah, I mean, the trip prior to that was like a few months, just short of 3 months. And it was totally different this time round, even though it was 8 weeks in America, but only three in Nashville.
Yeah. Tell the listeners, I mean, we were talking about gigs in New York.
Mm-hmm.
How did they go?
Yeah, they were great. I played in the Arlene's Grocery and played at the Rockwood Music Hall. Met McCartney as well. It was kind of, for some reason, I was on a bit of a roll there.
We were on that journey with you.
I mean, yeah, totally, because I was just keeping it. It was only fair for me to keep it going, yeah.
Then from New York, you moved over to
LA.
The West Coast.
Yeah.
So you were in LA. You did some gigs there.
Yeah, I played a couple of shows. I played at the Hotel Cafe, which is a prestigious venue, so it is, and played in a place called the Sayers Club.
Yeah.
So I was basically opening up. It was a bit different. Kind of like a industrial jazz kind of venue. Really cool. All the brick and... You can still see all the steel beams and everything. But I was basically opening for one of the best DJs, and Jay-Z's drummer was playing along with
him. Wow. So like, I know, it's surreal.
Only in places like that did that happen.
So, yeah.
And that was really cool. So
and then
only
from,
for a week.
Yeah, and then from LA, you went to Nashville.
Yeah, and back into Nashville. And it was, like I said, it was different from last time. It just felt like, obviously, I'd grown a bit more as a musician as well. I never planned anything in the way down, and the next thing I had all these gigs lined up, and wrote a song with Taylor and stuff like that. So there was a few things that went on, I loved it. Played a couple of shows right at the very end, the night before I left, which you saw was, I mean, even for me, it was quite an emotional one as well. Just that's maybe the way it goes, and as a musician, the ones pop up every so often.
How was it when Josh joined you?
It was great.
Yeah,
because it was a song that kind of started. I'm Not Giving You Up, which is another great song that I'm looking forward to getting out. I'd kind of brought an idea to the table, kind of, we kind of worked on it, and sat it to the side. We actually did a chorus, and I'm like, it's bugging me because it sounds like something, and it turned out it was like a hit. I can't remember.
Yeah,
I was like, scrap that. And I went back into the studio like 1 o'clock in the morning. I'm like, have to do this. Nailed the chorus just out there and then, and it was still like 3/4 done. And in Nashville, and I said to George, do you want to finish this song? We did it, and that was one of the ones we played. It just made sense. So it was around, but I got Josh up to do one of the songs. So
what's on? You've got a couple of gigs coming up.
Uh-huh.
Then you're heading off to Nashville.
Yeah, back.
And then you're back, and you've got more gigs.
Yeah, so it's going to actually make me feel like I'm a full-time musician.
And of course, the gig that I'm looking forward to, 28th of September.
Yeah, the Hugging Pint,
And we'll be up at the Hugging Pint to see that.
Yeah, the Darvel Music Festival on the 23rd as well. So that's always a good festival with some good acts.
Anyway, we joked earlier about if you were on the show again that you would end up getting the keys to the studio. I've got you something better. That's all I have. There you have it. An actual exclusive Urban Beat FM.
Well, you'll get a selfie tomorrow morning with it. That's fine. My coffee can go in that. It'll probably be honey and lemon, no doubt.
Yeah, I know.
Get in there.
There is something else. There is something else.
It should be me that's bringing you gifts. No, no. Honey.
And a token of my appreciation.
Is that all of it? Yeah.
For
I
my...
should be bringing it for you.
No, not at all. Not at all. Not at all.
Okay, I talk a bit spoiled, eh? What's going on? What do you like? So we'll have to crack that open at some point.
Yes.
So it'll have to be me and you, though.
Well, we can organise that.
And
it has to be after the end of September.
Oh, that's fine. That's fine.
So it does.
Great, thanks for that. That's really kind of you.
No, it's brilliant to have you in, Sean. Always a pleasure.
Yeah, thanks.
And always a pleasure to hear new music.
Yeah, it's good to...
So the album number two, are we probably... We're now probably looking at 2017.
Yeah, it'll be next year. Yeah. See how this trip goes and take it from there. Come back. I'm constantly recording all the time anyway, so when I come back, maybe October will be a bit more... Get it kind of laid down.
Yeah. A lot of people always talk about a second album as being the difficult second album, but from what I've heard there, I've heard Easier.
Maybe the third one.
I've heard Legacy. Yeah. I think number two is going to be
I'm excited about it because I always had that thought in my head, what's it going to be like? And people say that. But yeah, that's good.
Anyway, Sean, thank you very much for coming in. Yeah. Kieran's sitting there as well. He's got work in the morning. So have you, probably. You'll be in the studio. You'll be in the studio tomorrow.
9 o'clock, yeah.
Anyway, thank
sounds
you.
A bit different, but
we're going to finish. We're going to play a track that we alluded to, and we're going to play Sean C. Kennedy from 77. We've got to Love You All.
Okay. 107.2 Urban Beat FM.